Hello Leo, welcome to the channel, and this is going to be your weekly tarot reading, April 30th to May 6th, 2018. So the first card showing up, the topic of your week is going to be the Ace of Pentacles. The Ace of Cups, excuse me. The second card is going to be, this one represents the week, you know, the topic of the week. The second card represents the core of the situation, and this is going to be the High Priestess. Third card shows up, challenges that you need to overcome. This is going to be the Chariot card. And the last one will be guidance from Tarot for you for the week. Death card is what we do have. So it's going to be a week of changes for what it seems here, especially having the death card, guys, but it also a watery week. These are all water cards, which speaks for highly emotionally changeable week. All right, so your emotions are about to start changing and shifting, and this is going to be for the better. So that could be where you're gonna fall in love with someone, all right? And this is going to be a shared love, because you both here, as a core of the situation, have more than just emotional connection. You have connection in between souls, because into one relationship, this is what the High Priestess represents: emotion in between, a connection, excuse me, in between one's souls. It is a very potent emotional week, all right, regarding relationships. And actually, if you are single right now, this kind of like week, or these cards are a sign that your singularity, it is about to become to an end here during that particular week, because the Ace of Cups is a topic. It is also about very happy coincidences, all right? Or, in other words, bumping into somebody which is going to overflow your life with joy, and nothing will seem the same when you look at the world through that overflowing joy. In other words, you are going to transcend your daily reality, and nothing else is really gonna matter. I mean, as a poignant experiences from the past, so you will quickly forget your ex, you will quickly forget failures into one previous relationships, etc., etc. It is just, everything will be marvelous for you, because the person you're gonna meet, in case you meet somebody, is going to be very gentle, very caring. It's going to be someone that really shows you that you do care, that they do care for you, and they want to see you happy, etc., etc. But the Ace of Cups, it is not just the dream come true, guys. It is also could be a dream that you don't realize that you can have, all right? So it's something that surprisingly happens, and you didn't have it in your mind until now, but you recognize it as something very potent and very happy in your life, which, as I said, makes your current issues totally irrelevant for you, and you definitely have defined something else to look forward to. So as well, when we talk about career here with these cards, it is also about a happy coincidences, but here in career it is more like a passive week, all right, rather than an emotionally active one. And the core of the situation for career, it does speak that you are going to work very calmly and patiently, you know, you're not going to be bothered by anybody. And just on the contrary, everything that it is given to you to work upon you that week is going to give you a very big pleasure to do, all right? So it's going to be very interesting, and in the same time, you're going to feel like very confident and very capable to make it flawlessly. The only issue that the week presents is the Chariot card, and that speaks that you may break with the past way too harshly. All right, so it's kind of because you don't want to anymore remember the poignant experience, for example, from your relationship. You can jump into the new one without even reconnoitering what the person is all about. And as I said, not that they are going to be a bad match, all right, but maybe there is something into their behavior which you are not very well agreed with, all right, and you know, you will find out that you are a little bit aggravated and irritated by it further into the future, which may be a how can I place it, which could be a source of some issues But these issues are not going to be something major, so the relationship can't break. So very, very potent week in general. As I said, guys, very important here to be said is to follow your intuition and to follow the needs of your soul. In other words, follow your inner voice. And also, it is very likely that during this week, you may kind of sense stuff in a sense that you basically know things without even having a rational explanations. And when that happens, it is very important to go with your guts. And as I said, well, intuition is not exactly the correct word here, but I don't want to confuse you. Just follow your instincts. It is what I'm trying to say, because your instincts will be always, always right. And as I said, guys, try to change here as a guidance, try to be in peace with the past before you actually embark your new future, because the death card is the natural ending. It is not the forceful ending. And when you harshly jump into, for example, new relationship or new activities into your career and making that forceful break with the past is going to hit you further into the future. So try to achieve a natural break. In other words, be humble about what happened, be in peace with it, bury it in the past, and then move on for the brighter future which you are gonna have during that particular week. So that was your tarot reading for the upcoming week, Leo, and I hope you guys enjoyed it and you liked it. In case you're interested in a private reading with me, everything you need to know about it will be listed down there in the description of this video. Rad signing out now. See you next time. Bye.